Get ready to dive deep into a real-life cyber thriller. North Korean hackers have launched a brazen attack on the cybersecurity community using advanced social engineering, zero-day exploits, and sophisticated malware to infiltrate systems and steal valuable information. Google's elite threat analysis group, South Korea's analysts, and Microsoft's threat intelligence teams are all on their trail, uncovering stealthy malware vectors, weaponized vulnerabilities, and espionage campaigns targeting critical infrastructure. This is a wake-up call for the cybersecurity community and a battle of wits and wills. United we stand, divided we fall. Stay tuned as we dive into this ongoing cyber warfare and explore how we can defend against such great adversaries. For months, North Korean advanced persistent threat actors have been escalating wide-ranging cyber intrusion campaigns against the cybersecurity industry and research community. Their primary goal is simple, yet highly ambitious: comprehensively infiltrating our systems using social engineering, psychological manipulation, and advanced zero-day malware to establish persistent access. Investigators from Google's elite threat analysis group recently blew the whistle on the scope of this sophisticated scheme. The operation involved creating elaborate fake accounts on platforms such as X and Mastodon, specifically designed to connect with and earn the trust of respected cybersecurity experts through months of sustained engagement. After making initial contact in public forums and professional social networks like LinkedIn, the threat actors gradually shifted conversations to encrypted messaging apps like Signal, WhatsApp, and Wire. This slow burn approach methodically builds credibility and rapport, laying the groundwork for the eventual deployment of the endgame: tailored malicious file packing and at least one undisclosed zero-day exploit. So far, the weaponized vulnerabilities have been strategically leveraged to establish remote access, exfiltrate system data, capture screenshots, and hijack email communications. The stolen information is stealthily transmitted back to the hacker's robust infrastructure for analysis by the Reconnaissance General Bureau. While affected software vendors scramble to identify and patch the underlying flaws, this campaign highlights the continuously evolving sophistication of North Korea's cybersecurity units, notably Kabar Saja and StormCloud, opting to invest heavily in social engineering techniques over traditional technical exploits, displaying a cunning understanding of human psychology. Why spend valuable resources discovering rare software zero days when you can simply manipulate trust and leverage human nature? After months of rapport building, even the most security-savvy researchers can be fooled by a persuasive imposter persona. According to a detailed analyst of various now-suspended accounts across several platforms, this particular threat actor collective has been active since at least October of 2022. The hackers clearly possess advanced technical capabilities based on proof-of-concept Windows privilege escalation exploits they brazenly posted on GitHub, flaunting their skills. And this isn't their first deception effort involving an elaborate collaboration ruse. In July of 2023, different North Korean hackers created extremely convincing fake profiles on GitHub, posing as legitimate cybersecurity professionals and academics affiliated with Harvard and MIT. After organically earning the trust of targets through months of engagement, they eventually pushed weaponized repositories filled with data-stealing malware disguised as innocuous open-source tools. Beyond this ongoing and expanding zero-day deception initiative, Google's tag also identified another stealthy malware vector dubbed GetSymbol that has been hosted on GitHub since September 2022. Advertised as an easy way for revenge engineers to download helpful Windows debugging symbols, it promised to fetch data from Microsoft, Google, Mozilla, and Citrix servers. In reality, hidden functions in GetSymbol provided the threat actors with potent capabilities like arbitrary remote command execution, file exfiltration, and process injection, classic Trojan techniques that turned the two into a dangerous spyware backdoor. GetSymbol has also been actively maintained and continually updated until finally being taken down, highlighting the development time and strategic coordination invested into this two-pronged attack vector focused on penetrating the cybersecurity community. Meanwhile, South Korean cyber threat analysis also recently highlighted phishing emails originating from North Korean IP addresses containing weaponized LNK shortcut files. Once opened by unsuspecting victims, these exploits stealthily deployed data exfiltrating remote access Trojans with extensive capabilities to take control of the infected machines. At the same time, Microsoft's threat intelligence teams report that multiple North Korean advanced persistent threat groups have been simultaneously spying on Russian defense contractors and critical infrastructure companies, while also providing tangible support for Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Specifically, groups like Lazarus, APT-37, and APT-38 have aggressively expanded espionage campaigns targeting Russian aerospace, nuclear, and telecom firms since the war began. This likely indicates attempts to gather intelligence and technical secrets that could benefit North Korea's rapidly accelerating missile program. For the North Korean regime, cybersecurity and malware researchers arguably represent some of the most sought-after high-value intelligence targets. Compromising our systems provides their hackers with invaluable access to new zero-day research for exploitation, defense security insights to invade detection, and access to proprietary cyber tools and tactics. With global tensions continue to accelerate amid economic sanctions and pressure on North Korea to cease nuclear ICBM testing, hacking the cybersecurity community has obviously become a top offensive priority. Their hacking groups will continue to seek out ways to infiltrate our networks in pursuit of any advantage against perceived enemies. Bolstering defensive measures requires extreme vigilance against phishing attempts, thoroughly vetting and verifying any unknown online entities, trying to build connections, routinely searching for IOCs, and comprehensively securing systems against zero-day attacks. The best defense you can use is hitting the like button. But arguably most critical of all, rapidly disseminating threat intelligence and indicators of compromise across the global cybersecurity industry is absolutely vital to detecting and disrupting the operation of sophisticated state-sponsored adversaries like North Korea. While North Korea's technical cyber intrusion capabilities are certainly advancing at an alarming rate, by staying united, sharing knowledge, and quickly exposing attack methods, our community represents an unmatched defensive force. We must persistently call out and shut down emerging espionage schemes before they reach fruition in order to harden our industry against hostile foreign interference. Our field was founded on principles of transparency, cooperation, and the tireless protection of critical infrastructure, data, and assets. This escalating and brazen campaign should serve as an urgent wake-up call, reminding all of us why those defensive values and principles today matter more than ever before in our brief but storied history. Make absolutely no mistake, this threat to the cybersecurity community remains very real and is far from contained. As our daily working lives and global industry have become increasingly interconnected and dependent on digital technology, the risk of illegally breached data, stolen research, and disruptive attacks or sabotage spawned by stealthy nation-state intrusions also grow exponentially. Maintaining consistent vigilance of unsolicited files, collaboration offers, and publicly shareable threat intelligence remains absolutely essential for empowering and equipping our community to identify and withstand emerging digital threats. By collaboratively revealing North Korea's latest ploy, infiltration techniques, malware code, and infrastructure, we deal a massive setback to their espionage ambitions while simultaneously alerting peers across the industry. Though they will eventually regroup and return with fresh exploits, our collective resolve must stand firm in the face of this adversarial campaign. The integrity, security, and trust of the entire global community ultimately depend on our steadfast dedication to the principles and open practices upon which cybersecurity research was founded decades ago. United we stand, divided we fall. The future remains ours to shape. And that concludes our deep dive into North Korea's highly sophisticated and multi-pronged zero-day attack targeting the cybersecurity community across the world. While deeply concerning, let this also serve as a sobering reminder that we as an industry must stand together against emerging digital threats that undermine public trust and safety. Please share your own thoughts, insights, and defense strategies around strengthening our collective capabilities in the comments section below. The diverse integrity depends on open collaboration. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell for more cybersecurity news and threat research. Our mission to secure the digital future continues. Kindly join us in this mission. Stay safe and stay curious.